morning, everyone. Today is Wednesday, and I have a few things that I have to do today, so I figured I would take you along and show you what it's like being an entertainment host and journalist. First things first, I made a cup of coffee. Now we're gonna go upstairs. I have to write a script because I'm gonna be recording a segment for Black Instagram on Black Hollywood Live later on this evening. So I'm gonna write that script. I have an audition today for a commercial, so I'm gonna go and do that. I also have to finish watching Little Fires Everywhere. I don't know if you guys have seen it. Well, you guys haven't seen it, it's not out yet. But sometimes as a journalist or a host, you get screeners, which are basically, it's basically getting the episodes or the movie before they actually come out in theaters to the general public. So I have screeners for Little Fires Everywhere. I am gonna be interviewing the cast tomorrow. So that's something else that I have to do today. So it's gonna be a pretty busy day, and I thought I would just take you guys along. I don't know everything, but I figured I could just give you guys tips that I've learned so far, because I'm still learning, and they'll just be sprinkled throughout the video. So I hope you enjoy the video. Let's go. We have a long day ahead of us. So one of the very first things that I do in the morning is I get on my laptop, I sit down right here. This is kind of like my workstation, my recording area. I do everything right here. You've probably seen this area before, but I'll sit here and I will look through my emails. I'm registered through LA Casting, and that, ladies and gentlemen, is tip number one. If you are in LA, you are a host, you're on-camera talent, you should definitely register onto LA Casting. Different castings for background, commercials, modeling, they just kind of throw them at you and you can submit yourself. I don't usually apply for acting roles just because it's not my focus at this moment, but there are acting roles. It's cool to just submit yourself, put yourself out there and see what happens. It's already 8:45, so after this, I'm gonna get started on my script. So I'm actually not gonna go in to do my audition today. I'm gonna change it to tomorrow because they've given me that option, which is really nice. I just feel like my day is pretty much packed and trying to drive to go audition and drive back. LA traffic, it's gonna take too long. See you tomorrow. Okay, yeah, that should be fine because the junket starts around 12. I have to be there at 11:30 and it'll go until about 12:40. We only have 6 minutes with the cast. I'm gonna move my audition for a commercial over to Thursday.
Someone burned down your house with you inside.
I have always had the best intentions.
Someone burned down your house with you inside. Elena, do you know anyone that would do this?
So rent is $300 a month. I know about your little secret.
Hello from this side of the room, getting ready to go because I have to be over at AfterBuzz TV by 5:30 because I'll be filming my video segment for Black Instagram. It is currently 2:57 and I have to be there by 5:30, which means I need to give myself at least an hour and 15 minutes to get there. So 5:30 minus 1 hour is 4:30 minus 15 minutes, 4:15. Tonight will be my second time doing it. I can insert a little short clip right here of me doing it last week.
Coming in at number 3 is singer Jhené Aiko. She posted one of her photos from a feature with Billboard rocking box braids. These braids can take up to 8 hours to do, but they do last 4 to 6 weeks, and summer is coming. This photo received over 450,000 likes.
I do have a tip for you surrounding scripts. Do them ahead of time if you can. Don't be like me and do them at the last minute on the day of, if you can avoid it. If you have to, obviously, do it. I had to do that today, but if you have time, just do them the day before. That way, the day of, you can be practicing and going over it so that you feel comfortable with it. lot of the time, as a journalist or host, you are on the go, which means that you should probably pack some snacks, or else you'll end up at McDonald's getting a large fry for lunch like me. I already sent my script and everything in, so I'm really happy about that. I just need to make sure that when I get on camera, I'm giving energy, because that was part of the feedback that I got from last week, was that my personality doesn't reflect when I'm talking to the camera in the studio. So I'm working on that. I have a nice view of the city in front of me. You wanna see? That is downtown LA straight ahead. I live more south, so anytime I go to work of some sort, it's usually in the city over there. It's apparently golden hour at the moment. Just in case you saw me glistening in the sun, I wanted to give you a reason for it, because it doesn't make this much sense to be this gorgeous. Am I right? Okay, I'm done playing around. I need to be in there in like a minute. So I'm just gonna reapply some powder, make sure I don't look oily, shiny, sweaty, and then we'll go in.
All right. Also, I like had seen so much of the content that you're reporting on throughout the week, and you reported on like you've hit like a lot of interesting and like good headlines.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I tried to pick some that were relevant, but also had to do with beauty in some way.
All right, let's do this. Let me just get the network frame changed.
We're done. That's it. I'm back in the car. My taping is over. It's quick. It's like 15 to 20 minutes, 25 minutes. I feel like I did so much better than I did last week. I felt like my personality came out. I felt more alive. I felt more awake. I felt that energy that I feel normally, but I do feel like it came across on camera a lot better. That is something else I'm learning, is that when you're on camera, you're gonna have to perform even more. So you're yourself, but you are yourself times 10. You could be a really outgoing person, but on camera, it doesn't really translate that well, which is what happened to me. So I have to kind of be a little bit more excited and a little bit more into it than I normally would, so that you guys can feel my excitement. If you're not following Black Hollywood Live on Instagram, you should. We cover the latest Black Hollywood news, entertainment, culture, music, all of that fun stuff. And we just started this new Black Instagram segment situation. Follow BHL online on Instagram. Okay, let's go. It's hot in here. Sweet Jesus. Before I drive off, I have to tell you this. I made a dumb mistake, and I wore this green strapless shirt. And the reason why it was a mistake is because today I was on green screen. And you know, when you use green screen, you're placing a different background behind the subject. But because my shirt is also green, my shirt disappeared and it became the background. That's why I had my leather jacket zipped up, which was not a part of the plan. But it's fine. It's 7:53. I got home about 20 minutes ago. Just changed my clothes, put on something a little bit more comfortable. I'm gonna go downstairs, get a glass of wine, and finish watching these episodes of Little Fires Everywhere, because I need to have as much watched before tomorrow as possible. And I'm supposed to be sending in all my questions tonight by 9, and it's already almost 8, so. A little trick that I've been using for what seems like forever now is that I keep my makeup on if I really have to get something done, because the minute I take my makeup off, I'm instantly tired. So The trick is just keep your makeup on until you finish all your work. Then you can take it off and go to bed. It really helps me. Just try it out. Trust me. Let's go downstairs and get some wine. So tight. I did start going to the gym again, and this is just a theory, but I always stand up very straight to the point where I don't ever relax and let my bones rest. I just sit straight up all the time, which is not a bad thing, but I feel like that's why I feel so stiff and why my body just feels so good when it actually is stretched out. Just a theory though, I don't know. Oh. Yes, I did another outfit change. Only because I didn't really feel like wearing a dress anymore. So, anywho, I'm gonna go downstairs for a little bit and chill. I also need to eat something because I haven't eaten anything, which is not the best because it's 9:56 at this point. But good news, I did finish writing all of my questions for tomorrow and I got the okay. So I can chill for the rest of the night. I'm gonna make some coffee and do some more study. I'm actually looking for index cards to write all my questions on because it just looks a little bit more professional this small compared to having paper that's, you know, this big. I'd rather have index cards, but I'm hoping that I still have some. Ooh. Bingo. Two is all I need. So I made it to my destination. I only have 45 seconds on my SD card, so I'm gonna talk really fast. I am about to sit in the car and put all the questions I wanna ask onto these index cards. I have a lot of questions, but I'm gonna try and narrow them down. Maybe it's like 7 or 8, just in case I need them. I'm gonna go to the coffee shop and do some editing before I have to go to AfterBuzz because I have another show tonight for this show called Devs. I do the after show panel for it. I don't know if you guys have seen it, but it's really good. It's on Hulu. That's it. I only have a few seconds left, 35, 36. Wish me luck. I'll insert some clips here of how it went.
Playing kids in the 90s, but you guys weren't born yet during this time period, 1997. How was that for you? How about you, Lexi?
I've always been so infatuated with 90s culture. Aaliyah is like one of my biggest role models. Like, I just love her. And so I actually, like, during my very first fitting, I told Limpalo, our costume designer, I was like, I'm finally being able to live out my dreams of being a 90s teenager.
Anyone else that you dream of working with that you hope, you know, one day is on the same cast as you?
There are so many incredible artists out there. It's so hard to choose.
It's kind of lit.
It's honestly perfect.
It's so perfect.
Oh my goodness. We're so excited to be here. Welcome you guys to the Devs After Show on AfterBuzz TV. I am one of your hosts, Tyler Simone. And to my left, I have Miss Ashley Dior.
It's just us girls today.
It's just us.
Just us girls.
Yeah. Shout out to Ben and Rob. We'll see you guys next week.
Miss you.
Yeah, we miss you. But we'll hold it down.
Oh, yes. No doubts about that.